In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to create a Dolly Zoom or Vertigo effect using Adobe Premiere Pro. So stay tuned. The Dolly Zoom or Vertigo effect has been around a number of years. You know, Hollywood movies have been using it. With the recent announcement of DJI, they've announced two new drones, the Mavic 2 Pro and the Mavic 2 Zoom. The main sort of features of the Mavic 2 Zoom is to be able to create the Dolly Zoom effect. Now, this effect is actually quite easy to do, especially if you have Adobe Premiere Pro. I'm sure you can do it through other editing software. I'm just going to quickly show you how to do it here. Again, it's very, very easy. I've used this effect through a number of my videos. The higher the resolution of your video, the better, because what we're doing here is doing a digital zoom. You can do it through 1080p as well, but it's just that you'll be able to see some noise and the effect's not going to look as good as if you shoot it in 4K. Here's a couple of my examples. Okay, so now to do this, open up your editing software, in this instance Adobe Premiere Pro. I'm gonna drag the video into my timeline. I create my videos in 1080p. I've shot this in 4K, scale the frame size to become 1080p. And if you can see that Hong Kong clip that I've showed before, I'm gonna use it there, clear everything out. This is the original video. It is a little bit slower because I was moving slow, so I'm just gonna cut here to shorten the clip. I'm gonna quickly speed it up a little bit and make it about 5 seconds using the motion effect there, and go to scale, and you need to create a keyframe from the beginning and at the end. Now at the start, depending on the type of clip you've got, in this instance for this clip I am moving forward, therefore what I need to do to create this vertigo effect is to zoom out. So I'm gonna start off as zoomed in, create a keyframe using this, type in 165%, so it's gonna zoom in, go all the way to the very end of the clip, click another keyframe and put in 100%. And press play, and there you have it. You've got a Dolly Zoom effect. So you need to remember, if you're flying forward, you need to zoom out. So you're gonna punch it in first and then slowly move out. Again, you can adjust the, you know, how fast or how slow you want it to be. So you just play around with it. If I'm flying backwards, then I need to be zooming out to in. So I'll be zooming in. So here's an example of delete all the effects there. I'm gonna reverse the clip to pretend to make it look like I'm flying backwards. Again, go through your keyframes, go through the motion, select scale, go to your keyframe. I'll keyframe it at 100% first, then go all the way to the end, and then I'll put in 165. And yeah, so that's how you do it. The most important thing to be able to really sell this effect is to have a good composition of what you have in front of you. You want to have a good foreground and background to play with it, you know, to be able to zoom in while it's the background getting larger and larger. I think that's really important to be able to sell this effect to sort of inspire your viewers to watch your film or your videos. Remember, story is pretty important. Keep that in mind whenever you shoot your videos. And yeah, look, that's really it for me. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this quick tutorial, give it a like, I really appreciate it. And subscribe to my channel for more videos. Again, this is Dennis, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.